Today we're going to talk about how to install a TFT35 version 2 on a BigTree Tech SKR Pro version 1.1. Now keep in mind, the firmware may not be up to date for the TFT for the install, so I'm going to show you first how to connect the TFT to your board, and then I'll explain how to upgrade the firmware. After we do that, I will then show you how to install the Marlin firmware so that you can actually use it. Now, I did put almost in the center of the video the SD card that we'll be using. Now, you want to find something that's small, like an 8 gigabit SD card, because a larger SD card will give you problems loading the firmware. So keep this in mind. So here is the front of the TFT35 version 2. And as you can see, the only thing that we're really concerned with is that it has a touch screen. But to the right, at the bottom of the TFT, you can see that there's a reset button. The underside of the TFT35, and I need to point out a couple of points of interest, starting with the SD card on the left-hand side. And what that is this is what we're going to use to load our firmware on here. But we also have an SWD port right here. This is used for debugging. We'll probably never use it. Then we have our RS-232 down here, which we'll be using for our plug to connect our TFT cable. To the right of that, we have an expansion slot for TZ24. Then to the right of that, we have our automatic shutdown sensor. And then to the right of that over here, we have our filament runout sensor. Over here, we have our Wi-Fi port that we can attach a Wi-Fi module to use it remotely. And then we have a couple of expansion slots here, which I'm not exactly sure what these ports are for. So we're going to skip that for now. And on the bottom, we actually have more expansion slots running all the way across. And then we have our 5-volt input. And the last thing is a piezo buzzer, which is located right here. So to connect this, we're going to take the TFT cable right here. And we're going to find the notch side, which is on the back side of it. And we're going to connect that to our RS-232 port right here. Now keep in mind, you're going to have to trace out the cables to find out where they connect to from one end to the other in order to set yours up, but I'll show you in the video in just a moment how I will do it. So here's the pinout diagram for the RS-232 over here on the BigTree Tech version 2.0 for the TFT. So I want to point out what the pins are, because they have a reset pin, a TX pin, an RX pin, a ground pin, and a 5-volt pin. Now these are our pin alignments. Now notice that they may not be the same over here. This might be because the actual LCD or touchscreen may be flipped, but we'll figure that out in a moment. But this is how it appears on the pinout diagram. Now keep in mind, no one's paying me or sponsoring me to do these tutorials, but I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description to help you find these better, and possibly to help me out if you so choose to buy it. Here's the BigTree Tech SKR Pro version 1.1 pinout diagram. that I downloaded from BigTree Tech's GitHub page. Inside here, it says what the TFT pins are. So we have 5 volt, ground, TX, RX, and reset. So now we know how to actually connect the pins. I'm going to take care of that. So as you can see, we know that the reset pin is going to be over here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to align our pins up because we know our reset is this. So I'm going to align these first up and connect them like so. Then I'm going to connect the reset pin right here. In order to test this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to connect the big side of the USB with the 5 volt power jumper jumped, which is right over here, and the small side to the computer so that we can power the LCD. And as you can see, it's powering up just fine, but it still says no printer attached. So we're going to resolve that by using a firmware update, first of all. So to check our firmware to make sure that we're on the current version, we're going to go to settings. Then we're going to go to info. And as you can see, it says TFT V2.0.23. So that's not the current version. So I'm going to show you how to fix that. Okay, the first thing you need to do is open up a browser. And here's the website for the actual firmware that we need to upgrade. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to download it over here. And then I'm going to go to my folder for downloads and right click on the zipped file. And click on extract all. And now I'm going to extract. And I'm going to place a SD card in the drive. This will allow us to load the firmware on the drive to load on the LCD. Now I'm going to open up the folder, and inside here we have a bunch of different options. I'm going to destroy or delete a bunch of them. So we're going to actually do this one right here. And inside here I'm actually going to open this folder in a moment. I'm just going to delete these real quick. So now that this folder's open, we're going to limit it to our particular configuration. So I'm going to delete all the things that are not involved with our LCD. So as you can see, what I'm taking out is everything except for the BigTree Tech TFT35 API, or application 1, I think. Version 2. Now keep that in mind. And then inside here we have our bitmaps. So I'm going to copy all of this or send it to my TF drive. And once it's copied over, I'm going to remove the TF drive. Now with the LCD power disconnected from your board, you're going to connect your SD drive. Now you're going to power up your board. Now it's going to load the actual firmware, which is a bin file. This may take a moment. Now I've already done this once before, so if it's your very first time, it may ask you to touch your screen in certain places for the positions around the screen, little red dots and then a black dot in the center. It may take upwards of like 8 times to get it right, or at least in my case it did. So this is my second time doing it, so you may not see it. But as soon as this unified code or Unicode copies over, it's going to copy over the bitmaps and the icons to your TFT screen. So now that it's almost there, you're going to see the icons copy over. So it's updating, and now you're seeing the bitmaps copy over. After this, you may see the icons. Definitely a lot of bitmaps, as you can see. And now it's coming up. So what it says is no printer attached. Now I'm going to show you how to solve this problem. So first thing that we need to do is power down the system. Next, we're going to need to remove the TF drive from the Bigtree Tech SKR version Pro 1.1 and place the SD card in the drive. Then we're going to place this in the computer, and you may hear a beep. Okay, now that we need to do the Marlin part of this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to marlinfw.org. I'm going to click on download. And I want to show you a couple of things real quick here. This is the current release up here for 2.0. It's 2.0.3. And the nightly builds are right here. I prefer to use these. These are cutting edge, so there may be issues. These may have issues. And they may be reported down here with reporting issues. Keep in mind that there are a lot of issues that are reported. For instance, if you search on BL Touch and you press enter, it'll show you all the issues that occur with BL Touch or whatever else you're working with. Keep that in mind if you see something that may have worked in my video but hasn't worked since you've tried it. There may be a bug that's been introduced. So I'm going to go back here and I'm going to download the current bug fix. Then I'm going to go over to my downloads folder and I'm going to unzip the current version that's downloaded. So I'm going to right click, I'm going to go to extract, I'm going to click on extract. Now this may take a few moments. Keep in mind that the install for this is somewhat elaborate. So we're going to have a lot of steps to actually do just to do a simple LCD screen setup. So once it finishes, we're going to open up VS Code because Atom is no longer supported for the Platform IO plugin. So if you currently have Atom, you may need to update it because it probably doesn't work very well anymore with Platform IO. So it's almost done. So I'm going to click on Visual Studio's code or VS Code. I'm going to open this up. And inside here, to set up the actual motherboard for our build, we need to go to Source, Core, Boards.h, and we need to find board underscore BTT underscore SKR underscore Pro underscore V1 underscore 1 and copy that. Then we're going to close out of boards.h. We're going to minimize our folders here and we're going to click on configuration.h. What we're going to do is we're going to go to the top of the file here and search on motherboard. And we're going to highlight board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. And we're going to paste what we just copied. Then we're going to scroll up and we're going to change our serial port to negative 1. Then we're going to enable the other port and we're going to change this one to 1. Now keep in mind, this probably may need steppers in order to work, but we're going to test it with steppers. So I'm going to do a search on A4988 and I'm going to enable the X stepper, the Y stepper, the Z stepper, and E0. So we're all set here for the moment. So I'm going to go over to platformio.ini, and currently our chipset is the Mega 2560. So we need to change it to the one we're using. So we're going to search on SKR underscore PRO or Pro, and we're going to copy BigTree underscore SKR underscore Pro. Then we're going to go to the, back to the top, and we're going to highlight the Mega AT Mega 2560. And we're going to paste our chipset. Then we're going to do a build over here by clicking the build button. And this may take a few moments. Now that the compilation is actually finished, or the build, we can check on it right here to make sure that our chipset built, which it appears to have because it says successful. So to actually load it, we're going to click on .pio. Then we're going to go to the build folder. Then we're going to go to BigTree SKR and we're going to right click and we're going to say reveal in file explorer. Inside here, we're going to go into the folder and we're going to right click on firmware.bin and we're going to send it to our TF drive, which is right here. And let's take a quick look at the TF drive to make sure it copied over, which it has. Note the date and time is slightly different so that we know we have two different files. Now I'm going to show you how to load it manually. Okay, now that we have the SD card loaded and we have our TF drive, we're going to pop that out and we're going to place this in our BigTree Tech board for the SKR Pro version 1.0. And notice how I removed the SD card from the TFT display. Now I'm going to power it up because I have the other end connected to the computer. Notice how the firmware just loaded. And right now it says no printer attached. This is how we're going to fix that. We're going to go to menu. Then we're going to go to settings. And as you can see, the UART speed is 115/200, but the actual speed that we set up the firmware at was 250,000. So we're going to click on this. Now it's 250,000, so we're going to go back, then back again. And now it says attached, or it actually says that it's ready. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.